In Illinois' Wheeling Township, just northwest of Chicago, 156,000 people live in five separate communities. The Link Together Coalition unites them all and has a mission.
We need to prevent underage drinking for so many reasons. These are the future leaders of our communities. We want people to understand that these kids are going to be our future mayors, our future police officers, and we want to give them the best opportunity to have a successful life. We're really excited about the numbers that we've seen since our programs have been put in place. We've actually seen a 10% decrease in 30-day alcohol use in our teens.
Each municipality has its own police department, but they all work together with the coalition for the common goal.
It doesn't work unless you're invested. And we are invested in this program. We are invested to work with the coalition because we know we can make a difference. We know we can show a reduction in the number of offenses. We've proven that. We know that we can work with parents, schools, and we can work with the students to have what our goal is prevention in the first place.
A key to their success has been the implementation and enforcement of social host ordinances.
Social hosting is when parents provide a location for their underage teen to provide alcohol to their friends. One of the things we're trying to do is to publicize and make the community aware, A, that that is illegal behavior, educate the community on why that's a bad idea, and all the reasons why we as parents shouldn't do that.
If there's a party, underage drinking party in your house, whether you know it or not, whether you, for instance, a parent can be on vacation and leave their 15, 16, 17 year old home alone, you know, that's nothing wrong with that, it's not illegal. If a kid's gonna have a party, we wanna let the parent know that when you're away, if your son or daughter has a party, and somebody gets hurt or killed, you're responsible for that. And you could be arrested up to a felony charge.
We're able to hold the parents accountable for having these parties at their house. Sometimes parents feel like, let's just have them at our house. We can take the keys from them, we can monitor it, we can have a controlled situation. But unfortunately, it's hard to control every kid that's at that party.
I've heard over and over again, you know, officer, if my kid's gonna do it, I'd rather him do it home where I know where he's safe. And I'd rather have his friends here, so somewhere I don't know. You're accepting that your son or daughter is drinking illegally. So you're saying to your kid, that's okay, you're breaking the law, but that's okay. So I lose a little respect from a parent who's telling me that, yeah, I'm gonna let my kid break the law, it's no big deal.
Simply having a social host law on the books does not mean adults know about it.
Ma'am, social hosting and providing alcohol to teens is against the law.
We have been getting the word out to our teens and our parents through our schools, through our community partners. We most recently had a public service announcement that was developed by five of our police departments that we're very excited about. It's been shared on our partners' websites, through social media, local cable channels. It's been very, very well received, and it sends that message to parents that it's very important that they understand that social hosting is dangerous and illegal, and they should not be providing alcohol to minors.
Several liquor stores have also helped spread the messages that alcohol is illegal, unhealthy, and dangerous for teens by participating in a campaign called Your Actions Matter.
We go out and put the hangers on the bottles and the cabinet, the displays, and maybe that'll spark someone to say, what is that? What's that about?
And so when somebody comes in and they see this Your Action Matters tag, it's kind of a reminder, hey, just because you're an adult and you think it's okay to monitor and buy alcohol for the juvenile, we discourage it. And that kind of action is not gonna be accepted in our town or the surrounding towns who also participate in this. And then we also put up some flyers within their stores as well. So when people walk around, they can see this information.
The teens are the messengers, going into the stores and talking to salespeople and to each other.
It's good for them to be role models to themselves and to their other peers. So if they, you know, hey, this is what I was doing, why would you want to do that? Because it's important. You know, it may just sway one other person to say, you know what, that if they're strong enough to stand up for what they believe in, maybe I can do that too. So they can influence each other. It's a good thing for them.
Social norms campaigns are now a big part of the landscape, both in and around area schools. It's all about peer pressure working in a positive way.
Well, a lot of students hear kids talking about things that take place on the weekend. And so they start to overgeneralize that everybody is doing these things on a weekend. So there may have been a party where there are 15 or 20 kids at the party and they were drinking or using drugs. And they're talking about that. And they come back and they start talking about it within the school building. And then all of a sudden the rumors start to spread. Did you know how many kids were at parties this weekend? And they start to overgeneralize the whole fact of how many kids are really out there partying every weekend. So we are actually looking at the difference between kids' perceptions and actual use. Because a lot of kids think everybody's using, but when we actually interview students and we do surveys with students, the Illinois Youth Survey, we find out that that's not the case. The majority of our kids are not using, and yet that message doesn't get out, and all the kids think everybody is. So when you go around our building, you see these posters that talk about, did you know that so many students at Buffalo Grove High School are not using drugs, right? Because we want to get a positive message out to kids. We don't want kids to think that everybody uses, because they don't.
The coalition's success is based on partnerships and consistent messaging.
Yeah, it's not just school or church or the police or you know doctors or social workers. It's all of us working together to make a difference. Because then it creates an environment and an atmosphere of this is the positive health choice that we're making for ourselves and for our community.
Even though Link Together has had tremendous success, it wants to do even more to help teens stay away from alcohol.
Drinking does not have to be part of high school, and that's something that we're really working hard to reinforce. That would be the result of one bad choice could alter the rest of their life, their family's life, and the lives of all their friends and the entire community.